Hello all, so we will be starting with energy band model and we will focus on how bands are formed and then we will start with energy band diagrams. So first of all, let's consider a single silicon atom. So as we all know, it has 14 electrons. So it is being configured as 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, okay, and then 3s2 and 3p2. And so we can say that it has 4 number of electrons in its valence orbit. And as we move in this direction, that is from left to right, we have increasing energy levels. All this indicates the energy levels and it is being increasing, as we all know. So first of all, let us just draw one graph of energy. So on y-axis we are having energy, and over here we are having interatomic distance, that is distance between two atoms. So let me draw first different states. This is 1s2, then this is, let me draw with the same color, 2s2, 2p6. And now this is 3s2 and this is 3p2, right? This is the interatomic distance. So as we all know that as per Bohr's model, what we can say, we say that energy is having quantum states, that is in an atom we have any quantum states of energy, that is all energy states are not possible, the electrons will have some specified state. So these are the states. So we can say that inside a silicon atom, these are different energy levels. The energy level in between these two, in between any of this energy levels, is not possible. The if you inject that energy level in the silicon atom, then it will reject it. And this is the property of nature, we can say. So it will not accept this anymore. So these are states, different states. But what happens, these are at far distance, that is interatomic distance is larger. But what happens as we move towards, that is if interatomic distance is decreased. So if we move this side, that is if we decrease the interatomic distance, then what happens, they will start to split. It is this type of, suppose two atoms are interacting, the two will split, then again other four are interacting, then four will split, then if eight atoms are interacting, then split. The same thing is valid for this also, okay. But these levels will not split. They will split, but at very small interatomic distance, because they are far inside. Okay, these are our valence orbits, so they will split first. They can also split, but we will not consider this into our discussion because we are not concerned about the electrons which are inside. We all are concerned with this valence electrons. Okay, so this happens, this splitting happens, and this splitting happens because of Pauli's exclusion principle, as we all know. Yeah, I hope you all know Pauli's exclusion principle. So this splitting occurs because, if someone asks you the reason why this splitting occurs, then you can say due to Pauli's exclusion principle. So as more and more number of atoms interact, the energy levels are splitted further and further. And now let me draw the resultant figure. Okay, and that figure will show us how a band is formed. Actually, this formation is of band. And now let's see how this is formed actually. So again, I am drawing. Okay, and this figure is very much important. Again, 3p2. And then 3s2, then 2p6, 2s2 and 1s2. Okay, these are not in our concern, so we will neglect those. But yeah, they can split. Suppose we are going very far inside, then they can split. Okay, but their effect is very much negligible, so we neglect them. Now, how to draw this diagram? So what we will do, as we all know, they will get splitted. So as per the Pauli's principle, suppose at this distance they get splitted, so they will split and again they will increase. I will tell you the reason why they are again increasing, but for just now, first let me draw this. And again here also they will increase. Clear? So this increment occurs, and this is obviously energy, and this is our interatomic distance. So what happens that they will get splitted. So earlier we said that the electrons have specified state of energy, that is, in between these two states the energy is not possible. But what happens as we decrease the interatomic distance, this is possible, that electron will now have the energy state between these two. Okay, though these are in these two are allowed energy states, and in between all this the state is also allowed. So it means that it forms a band, it is band of energies. Okay, so initially let me draw with some light color. That let's say this is just for understanding purpose. Let's say this is E2 and this is E1, and initially when the band was not formed it is E0. I hope it is visible. Yes, this is just for understanding. So initially the electron in 3p2 state, obviously this is 3p2, okay, and this is 3s2. So in 3p2 state initially only this E0 energy state is possible, that is, electron can have energy E0 only. No energy other than E0 is present in the electrons, okay, present with the electrons in this state, 3p2 state. But what happens, due to decrease in interatomic distance there is a splitting of band. So now let's say these two are extreme ends, that is E2 and E1. So now the energy states, allowed energy states in this 3p2 is between E2 and E1, that is, any of the state in between can be allowed. So this is called formation of band. And you may ask now that why this increment is happening, that is, still as we are moving further and further, okay, inside, that is, interatomic distance is further increased, then there is an increment. Okay, so why is increment? Because of nuclear repulsion. Because when two atoms are very near to each other, then their nucleus also repel, so their potential energy will increase, and due to this, this increment is there. Okay, so let me write this. That just neglect this yellow lines now. This yellow lines are just for understanding purposes. So now let me draw the, let's say this is now E top and this is EC. Okay, that is conduction band. Now this is EV and this is E bottom. Oh, let me draw again. So just I am drawing it once again. So just redrawing it again, this is energy and this is interatomic distance. Okay, so just I have redrawn. So obviously some electron will have the limit of energy state, that is, energy which it is having, it has some limit. So let's say this limit is E top, and in conduction band this lower limit is EC. And similarly, in this 3H2, we have EV and some bottom limit. So this is called actually conduction band. This whole band is called conduction band, and this hole is called valence band. Clear? So, and in between this, that is, okay, this is our forbidden gap. That is our band gap, we can say. Okay, so now let's consider two points. First of all, this is called band gap, it is denoted by EG. Okay, gap. So at this point Q, okay, what happens? This is the band gap. So what we can say, at this point Q, generally the interatomic distance of the interatomic, it is the interatomic distance, we can say this Q, it is the interatomic distance of the silicon crystal, semiconductor crystal. It means that whenever there is interatomic distance of this order, that is from, this is origin obviously, so from origin to Q, if this much amount of interatomic distance is there, then our crystal is a semiconductor crystal. Clear? So electron in this semiconductor crystal can have energies like 1s2, which we have not drawn over here, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, then in between EV and E bottom, and in between E top and EC. But it cannot have energy between this EC and EV. And this region is called